Hello viewers, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to learn about the residential status of individual. So for this purpose, we should know the basic concepts like what is residential status, how many types of residential status are there, how to determine, that means how to compute the residential status, is there any conditions are there, any rules are there. So from this video, we are going to learn all these three concepts. What are this means? What is residential status, how it is interlinked with the income tax, the second point, types of residential status, and the third one, what are the conditions are there to determine this residential status. Now coming to the first point, what is a residential status? So what is this residential status? When it comes to income tax, the term residential status has nothing to do with the nationality. It is not related to the nationality. A person may be an Indian or American, but due to the residential status, an Indian person may be called as non-resident of India, and in the same manner, an American person may be called as a resident of India. Why this? Because the residential status of a person depends upon the territorial connections of the person with the country. What is this territorial condition means? That means for how many days the person is staying physically in India. So this physically staying in India will be accountable for computation of residential status. He may be an Indian or American or Japanese or Chinese, but when he is staying in India for more than few days, according to the conditions, the person will be stated as a resident of an India, and he have to pay income tax to the Indian government, not to the other countries. So that's why for computation, the first step in the income tax will be, we have to calculate the residential status of a person. According to the residential status only, the person will be liable to pay tax to the government. So here what we are able to understand means, even though the person is an Indian or American or Japanese or any other person, if a person is a resident in India, then the person should pay tax to the Indian government. That's why the residential status computation part is very important. Let's see few important points to be considered under residential status of individual. First point, the residential status of an individual will be determined according to the previous year only, not in the assessment year. What is this previous year? What is this assessment year? What is this financial year? I have discussed in another video. I have given that link in the description. Then the second point, dual residential status also is possible. That means he may be called an Indian resident, and at the same time he may be called as a resident in America. This is possible. And the main important amendment in the year 2020 to 2021 was, an individual who is an Indian citizen not liable to pay tax in any country, then he will be deemed to be an Indian resident and he will be liable to pay tax in India. Now you understood what is the importance of residential status. Now coming to the second point, how many types of residential status are there? The residential status is actually divided into two different categories, resident and non-resident. This resident is again divided into two different categories, a resident and ordinary resident, and the next one is resident and not ordinary resident. So how to determine whether the person is a resident or non-resident means we have some basic conditions. So let's see the point number three, what are the conditions. To determine the residential status, two conditions are described under Chapter 6 of Income Tax Act. The first one talks about the basic conditions, which is described under Chapter 6, Subsection 1. What does this basic condition means? These conditions will determine whether the person is a resident or non-resident. If the person is declared as resident, when we go through these conditions, if the person is declared as a resident, then the resident, the person should be declared whether the person is ROR or RNOR. For this purpose, we have additional condition. So first of all, let's see what is this basic condition. So Section 6, Subsection 1 talks about the basic condition. If any one condition or both the conditions are satisfied by a person, then that person will be called as a resident of in India. If both the conditions are not satisfied, then the person will be declared as non-resident of India. first condition, he must be in India for 182 days or more than 182 days in the relevant previous year. So what is this relevant previous year means? For example, the assessment year now is 2020 to 2021. For this previous year means 2019 to 2020. Now coming to the second condition, he must be in India for 60 days or more in the relevant previous year and 365 days or more in immediately preceding to the four previous year. Let's understand this basic condition with the help of an example. See the example, Mr. Pradeep Kumar, a citizen of India, left to Japan on 2nd February 2020. They are asking what is the residential status of Mr. Pradeep for the assessment year 2020 to 2021. Remember one point carefully, that we have to compute the residential status of an assessee for the previous year only, not for the assessment year. So what is the previous year 2019 to 2020? That means we have to compute how many days the Pradeep is in India from April 1st, 2019 to March 31st, 2020. So see, he left in India. See the question, he left to Japan from India on 2nd February 2020. That means from past he was staying in India only. That means approximately how many months he was in India? April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December, January. January full month he was there, and February 2nd he was leaving India. That means approximately 10 months he was in India. That means how many days? Approximately 300 days he was in India. What is the basic condition whether to determine whether Pradeep is in resident or non-resident means? See the basic condition. The first condition is he must be in India for 182 days or more. Or see the next condition. What is the second condition? 60 days in the previous year and 365 days in the four preceding previous years. That means in the previous year only, how many days the Pradeep was staying in India? 300 days. That means the first condition is satisfied. If any one condition is satisfied, the person will be declared as a resident. So here approximately our answer is saying that Mr. Pradeep is a resident of India. So let's check the second condition also. What is the second condition? He must be in India for 60 days in the previous year. In the previous year, yes, he was staying. Approximately he was staying in India for how many days? 300 days. 60 days they are asking. Yes, he was staying in India. And 365 days relevant to the four preceding previous years. That means, what is this four preceding previous years means? So what is the assessment year? Assessment year is 2020 to 2021. For this relevant previous year means, what is the relevant previous year? 2019 to 2020. Preceding that previous four previous year, that means preceding, that means before that 4 years, that means 2018 to 19, 2017 to 18, 2016 to 17, and 2015 to 16. These 4 years, the total of the 4 years, the total amount of days he should be in India means 365 days. We don't have any information regarding the previous years. They just said that he left to Japan on 2nd February. So we are assuming that Pradeep is staying in India only. That means total 4 years he is staying in India. That means 365 days every year, 4 years he was staying. But what they are asking? They are asking that the total 4 years he must be in India for how many days? 365 days. Yes, he was satisfying that condition also. So here we are determining that Mr. Pradeep is a resident of an India. How we are determining that the person is a resident means we are going through the basic condition. So if any one condition or both the conditions are satisfied, then the person will be declared as a resident. Here Mr. Pradeep is satisfying both the conditions. He is staying in India for the previous year for more than 182 days, and moreover 60 days in the previous year and 365 days preceding the four previous years he was staying in India only. That's why the person is declared as a resident of India. So I think you understood the concept of basic condition and why the residential status is important and how it is related to the income tax. So let's learn the additional conditions in the next video. If you like my way of explanation, please like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.